Today we're going to look at what I consider to be the best watercolour lifting off brushes. Now what I want to do now is lift off some marks within this ear, because you can see from that reference photograph just there, okay, so the one, that within that ear there's all these little white gaps and the little white fine vein lines that we can see. So I want to lift some of those off and probably blend them a little bit with detail around those lifted off areas as well. But to do that, what I need to use is something like that. I know, well, that's my homemade version. Okay, it's basically an old brush which I flattened with a pair of pliers and then trimmed it down with a Stanley knife, little blade or craft knife, anything like that will do it, to create like a little fine lifted off area. And this is a stiff bristled brush, okay? And I think you can buy them for like £5 in a cheap shop, you know, which are really handy. I've got that, but see what I've also got? I've just bought in two new ones to test out. Now these are from Rosemary and Co. So that's mine, obviously, as you can see. So these are from Rosemary and Co. And it's a Series 502, size 2, and a small Rosemary and Co. Eradicator. So let's try the Eradicator one first of all. So it's a stiff bristle brush, or fairly stiff anyway, as you can see there. It's not too bad. So I'm going to dampen that down. So wet it, tap it a couple of times on a kitchen roll like that. And then we need to start lifting off some details. All right, here we go. Let's give this one a try and see how well it performs. I don't know where to go first, actually. Let's try around here first of all. So I'm just going to add a little bit of a line here. Just going over the same line time and time again. Then once it's still wet, tap it. And you can see that's taking off a little bit of detail there. And that's great. That's exactly what I want. Let's do another one a minute. Around there. You will have to keep washing this out though. Because if you don't, what will happen is that you start moving paint from one place to another. And we don't want to do that really. Not really. Let's take a little bit more around there now. Okay. Rinse that out. And see, it's quite a sharp line actually, that, isn't it? It's not too bad. As long as you try and keep it level, or keep it straight, if you know what I mean, on its thinner edge. So I'm just going to do a little line here. The more times you go over it, the more paint you'll lift. And obviously lifting the paint will depend on the paint properties. Is the paint staining or not? And so on. So you have to bear that in mind when you're doing something like this. So I'm going to just use a different technique now, just by dragging it slightly and lifting. And that's created a nice highlight coming up this ear, hasn't it? Let's just do the same with this one here now. Probably a little bit lower. And that way you're not getting a very sharp edge. I don't need a really sharp edge everywhere. Just a suggestion of light showing through. Something like that. And you see already that's working really, really well. Oh, like this. Oh, yeah. It works very much the same as my own made one, as I mentioned. Very, very much the same. So if you don't want to buy one, try making your own. If you're interested in looking at how to make one of these, have a look at the link to the top right for different ideas on how to make your own kind of detail or technique brushes, special effect brushes, that sort of thing. Let's switch to the other one now. So away from the Eradicator, let's go for this one, which is a Series 502. And you can see with this one, look, that's a chiseled edge. I don't know how sharp this edge is, though. Let's just try that. Not very. So it might not give quite a defined lift-off area. Just try around there a minute. It's certainly a stiffer bristle, as you can see here. So lift. Well, it's lifting the paint off all right. I do find that you've got to be careful, though, with stiffer bristle brushes. You find that if you go a little bit too heavy-handed, you start to damage the watercolour surface underneath. And if that happens, then it's very difficult to repair. You can use watercolour ground. Daniel Smith had one, so you can put some imitation watercolour paper on, that's what I call it anyway, over the top, and then you can sort of semi-repair it. It works most of the time. So remember, if you haven't got one of these and you don't want to buy one, those old brushes that you're about to throw away, well, save them. And if it's a round brush, flatten it out with pair of pliers, as I said, trim it down and make yourself something like this one here. Shall I just show you that one a minute? And how that one works. Yeah, let's have a go. So this is my homemade one. And we're going to drag in a little bit of a line here. It's not quite as defined, this one, but I quite like that for this ear. Because on this elephant ear, as you can see there, that these lines are not, they're not sharp, not really sharp. But I must admit, the synthetic white bristle brush, which I quite like, the little tiny one I've just shown you, I prefer that one over the three, really, at the moment, because that one's quite quite defined, really, especially for those finer marks that we can see within these veins in the ear. And you can see that works really well. It's not too bad, actually. See, my homemade one. Yeah, you see? And you can scumble it like that. Don't press too hard, remember. And how far you can go depends on your paper type. It really does. Because some papers, you find, will not allow a lot of scrubbing. I do find that with this Bockingford paper, it's got good lifting off properties, which is what I like about it. I can see a very fine one just going through here. So I switched again to that finer brush. Look at the fine lines I can pick out with this though. I do like it for that. I'm very impressed, I must admit, you know. Excited. I like having a new brush.